top of Pikes Peak. We're just below the summit here. We're at about 12,000 feet.
It's quite an honor to get to sponsor a race that's been one of the nation's oldest races. It's the 91st running year. And to be able to be standing on top sponsoring the electric class is quite an honor and a unique opportunity for clean cities at a national level.
We want to stop global warming. So this electric vehicle race is our campaign.
It's fabulous to be competing here with the electric vehicle. They're running in the electric class. And you know, these two cars are not too shabby.
It's the only event in the world where electric race cars compete with gas engine race cars at the same race. So it's absolutely incredible.
This is our first time sponsoring this event, and we sponsored it because of the competitiveness of the electric vehicle class. So we saw it as a unique opportunity to get electric vehicles highlighted and also supporting the mission of clean cities, which is overall fuel reduction and transportation.
The car was conceived as a rolling test bed for advanced electric powertrain development and also rapid charging technology. This allows us to charge the whole car in just over an hour. That's an incredible performance benefit for us as a race team. So that's the sort of technology that in the future will be able to be used for production and street cars to enable charging far more quickly than it's enabled now.
So to see them put under a high stress situation racing up the mountain, and to see the electric class being as competitive as it is, adds a lot of promise for the future of electric technology.
Today we're at the 91st running of the Pikes Peak International Hill Climb. We've got about 150 competitors ready to go and try to attack Pikes Peak.
Exciting and pretty frightening at the same time.
Our course is 12 and a half miles long, 156 turns. We see speeds upwards of 140 miles an hour in some sections. We've got gas-powered vehicles, electric-powered vehicles, propane-powered vehicles.
Pretty incredible event. It's not like anything I've ever done.
Because of our elevation gain, where we start at 9,000 feet and go up to just over 14,000, so we almost gain a full linear mile, combustion engine cars lose sometimes up to 40% of their power between the start line and the summit. Electric vehicle doesn't have any of that. It's just as strong at the start line as it is at the summit.
It's funny to see the electric bikes beating the gas bikes on the time trials.
The Pikes Peak Hill Climb wants to continue to be on the cutting edge of technology, and the Clean Cities Coalition wants to continue to show that the cutting edge of technology is a viable option, and especially in automotive industry that, like we've seen in the last few years. So it really is just a perfect marriage.
It's clear from this weekend, from the numbers that are being posted, the fastest bike yesterday was an electric bike, and I think it's a way of the future. As more R&D and investment gets done, the bikes and the cars are getting better.
Electric technology has come so far, and it has so much further to go, and the sky's the limit.